What's up, guys? IDK Play here, coming back with a brand new NASCAR E5 news video. And today we are going to talk about every new feature coming into NASCAR E5 that we know about so far. So just a disclaimer, we might get news later down the line about new features coming into the game, but this video is based on new features that have been announced to be in NASCAR E5 up to this point. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. Starting off with a feature I've yet to mention in a NASCAR E5 news video is that we will be able to create our own schedule for tracks, and I'm going to take the obvious guess that is for season mode since it wasn't mentioned what category this was for. Now, I'm pretty sure you remember this, but in NASCAR E4 we had schedule presets, and from the looks of it, this year we will finally be able to make our own schedules in season mode. The next new feature coming into NASCAR E5 is from the career mode side, and that is improved statistics. Now, we have known this for a while now, and from the looks of it, I don't think career mode is going to have a lot of new features, but it's nice to see that they did add this into NASCAR E5. Next on the list is the challenge mode, which is basically online challenges that give you race scenarios to complete, and honestly, I am 100% on board with this because the future of NASCAR gaming is through multiplayer, and NASCAR E4 lacked multiplayer features, so this should spice up that side a little more. Next are test sessions, and if you're a player that loves to make custom setups, you should be doing backflips right now because you won't have to worry about AI cars being in your way, and honestly, test sessions coming into 5 should get more praise. Next is something I am actually very happy about, and that is we get to finally color our spoilers and rims for our custom cars. We haven't been able to do that since NASCAR 15, and small changes like that adds more creativity to the game. Along with that, the paint booth in NASCAR E5 will also get new number fonts, which are good because the ones in NASCAR E4 are pretty dull. Next, we finally have player DNFs, so we can finally say goodbye to flipping 5 or 6 times and still being able to drive away. Honestly, it's about time we got this feature, and I just hope this feature is also available in multiplayer. The next new feature we are getting are new camera views when driving. Now, we don't know how many camera views we'll be able to get, but up to this point, we know about one new camera angle, and that is a far third person view. So if you're not a fan of the third person camera we have right now in NASCAR E4, you can finally try a new point of view when racing. And finally, the last thing I am going to confirm in this video is that the Indy Road Course will be in NASCAR E5, and we know this because Taria put out a mention saying NASCAR E5 will have all official 2020 NASCAR tracks, which includes the Indy Road Course since that is now ran in the Xfinity series. So that is all the new features we know about up to this point, which is a lot more than people think, and just to let everyone know, there are new NASCAR E5 features that have yet to be announced, and NASCAR E5 has cool new stuff like the Tony Stewart paint schemes, the Tony Stewart spotter audio, the Sunoco paint schemes, and hopefully soon we will get to see how the physics are. So that will do it for today's video. Thank you guys all for watching. If you're new, please don't forget to subscribe to this channel because we are less than 400 subs from 14,000 subscribers. And if you did enjoy this video, please support me by dropping a like and commenting down below your opinions about NASCAR E5. So I'll see you guys in my next NASCAR E5 news video. Please don't forget to subscribe with notifications on so you don't miss another NASCAR E5 news video. IDK out.